Hello everyone, today we are going to continue the last lesson by Alfonso Daudet. Students, we have completed the two modules of this chapter and studied about the importance of a language, especially of the French language, mother tongue of the French people, that we were discussing at the time of Franco-Prussian War. At that time, the two districts of France, Alsace and Lorraine, they were handed to Prussia. And after that, there was an order came from Berlin that tomorrow onwards there would run German language. So that was the order. And after that, we are just studying about a child, French. So French's story, when he entered the classroom, he just found the complete environment was changed, because whatever here just going on, that was the impression of that particular order. So we just ended that part of M. Hamel's words as he was taking his last lecture and explained before the villagers and students. He just also explained about the importance of French language. French language was the most beautiful language in the world, the clearest, the most logical, that we must guard it among us and never forget it, because when people are enslaved, as long as they hold fast to their language, it is as if they had the key to their prison. These are the words of M. Hamel, and by these words somewhere M. Hamel just going to explain his own patriotism and also just wants to preserve this language in among of all the French people. So he just explained here first of all about the importance of mother tongue, the French language. Yes, simply he said that it's the most beautiful language. Later on he also explained that whatever the concept we are understanding now, simply we are understanding now in the French language. And again he explained that it's the language, because when we people will be enslaved life, then this language will help us to just come out from this prison. Because one day we will achieve our freedom and then this language will be helpful to us. So further M. Hamel shows his dedication by this word, by his lecture. He just shows his somewhere his dedication, because he served here in the school 40 years. And the school, that was nothing changed. All these things were same, because he just planted the flowers, the gardens. He looked this school like his home. The desk and the benches had worn smooth. Only in the classroom, the desk and the benches, they had worn smooth. And the walnut trees that grew outside, they were taller. Hop vine reached to the roof and so on. These were the changes that noticed into the classroom. Except of that, there were no any changes. And also this shows somewhere M. Hamel's dedication to the school. So here comes the question. Describe M. Hamel's dedication and devotion to French language. So student, you are explaining here about the dedication and devotion of French language, of M. Hamel towards the French language, okay? After that, M. Hamel shows his courage, because he was just taking his last lesson, and on that particular day he delivers his last lesson in of history. And then after grammar lesson, the students were also taking these lessons. And the situation of laugh and cry, because at that time France noticed of old Hoscher. Old Hoscher was taking his primer book and reciting the alphabets in French language. And that was a very shameful condition, because on the last day we are reciting the alphabets in French language. So this is the situation, has come here, a laugh and cry. Because on that day, as we are just laughing on Hoscher or just crying on the today's situation, as from tomorrow onwards they won't run this French language. So there has come the situation of laugh and cry. And the tears roll down from the eyes of the listeners. Everyone gets emotional in that particular last day. So there comes a question. The people in the story realize suddenly how precious their language is to them. How did they realize it, and who made them realize it? We all know that by hearing the words of M. Hamel, everyone got shocked, and also the order came from Berlin So that's why everyone on that particular day interested to take their last lesson. Okay. Amhemal shows his patriotism, and he just explained here, this is the time of church clock strikes 12, and also the time of when the trumpets of the Prussian soldiers sound was coming through the window. Amhemal at the time became too emotional. He just wants to say something before the class, but unable to say. And so just go on the board, on the blackboard, and wrote some words, Vive la France. And just by his hands waved to the class to dismiss the last lesson, last class. Leaves school by making a gesture with his hand. The school is dismissed, you may go. So now this is the time when Amhemal was feeling too remorseful, too regret, and also showing his patriotism to the country and to also the language, French language, because from next onwards he would leave this place, and from there would be coming the new teacher, and he will teach them German language. So why did Amhemal write Vive la France on the blackboard? So Vive la France, long live France, we all know that about the meaning of this particular word. So we have to explain about the particular, we have to explain about Amhemal's feelings, his emotions. Why did he just write this word on the board? Okay. So student, the story is going to end, but having the main thing is here, and the story completely focused on the linguistic Shaunism. Linguistic Shaunism, it's a word, because in that feeling a people who has carrying the pride in one's language too far. But rather this concept is completely true here in this concept of the chapter, because there is a contrast in the concept of Alsacian Lorraine. Because in Alsacian Lorraine, the people are French, the French people, they are not going to continue their language too far, so somewhere they are also leaving their language. German is being imposed on the French people. Amhemal's love for French language also shows here. He explained that this is the most beautiful language, that shows somewhere his linguistic Shaunism. And also the importance of mother tongue, he just explained here. And after all, Amhemal's plea to guard this language among themselves, because language is the key to freedom. Okay, so friend, this is the end of the chapter, but there is a question, what is the linguistic Shaunism? Explain the statement in reference to Amhemal's views about this language. Okay, so hope you understood this chapter. There are some questions you have to attempt. How does Amhemal prove to be an ideal teacher? We have all great deal to reproach ourselves with, said Amhemal. Comment on this point. Okay, so thank you for watching. Hope you understood this video.